As we have seen in tutorial 3, constraints can be applied at spatial scales. FPS Atlas can accommodate variations in the spatial scales that constraints are applied to through its hierarchy of spatial units. In total, there are 4 mandatory spatial units: range, axis unit, zone, and polygon. Each polygon must belong to a zone, a zone must belong to an axis unit, and an axis unit must belong to a range. Additional optional spatial units within FPS Atlas are cliques, superblocks, raster cells, and roads. In tutorial 3, we applied the constraint set NoHarvest to a zone. This tutorial will show you how spatial constraints can be applied at various scales. First, we have to create a rule set that we name RSV plus adjacency. We create our new rule set by right-clicking into our rule set editor, selecting new rule set, and then we enter the according information. We find our new rule set down here in the rule set editor. We right-click into the empty area in our new rule set and select configure flows to configure the time horizon of 240 years that we are going to look at. So we choose time increment steps of 10 years and number of periods being 24, adding up to a total of 240 years, and click OK. You can see that the flow targets that have been automatically entered are now 100,000 cubic meters per decade, and we have to adjust these. We start with a flow target of 200,000 in the first decade, and then lower our flow targets by 5,000 cubic meters per decade until we reach a flow target of 155,000 cubic meters per decade in year 100, and we will maintain that flow target for the rest of the years. Your completed table should look like this. Now we want to add the NoHarvest constraint set that we created earlier, and to do so we go to our browser window, we double click on the reserve zone, and then add the NoHarvest constraint set to our newly created rule set. Additionally to our old constraint set, we will now create a second constraint set, the adjacency constraint set. We choose Create New Constraint Set from the according menu. We select Green Up Age and type 20 years into the according box. Save the new constraint set by closing it, accepting the changes to the new constraint set, and give it a name, in this case adjacency constraint. Now we can apply our new constraint set to a spatial unit. Go to the browser window and find the axis unit tab. Click on it and you will find a single axis unit listed, and it should not have any constraint sets assigned to it. Double click on the axis unit to open it, and in the according window highlight the constraint set or duration, press Ctrl and the down arrow, and add a line. In this drop-down list, you should now be able to not only find the NoHarvest constraint, but also the newly created adjacency constraint. Select the adjacency constraint and confirm your changes by closing the window. To find out what effect our new adjacency constraint has on our harvest flows, we carry out a new run. We do so by opening the according window and then pressing the start button. Your results show a typical sawtooth pattern. It has peaks approximately 20 years apart from each other, and remember that we adjusted a 20-year adjacency constraint. So this is the classic pattern that develops when adjacency constraints are applied and the model has to struggle to meet the harvest flow targets. Now modify your harvest flows in your rule set RSV plus adjacency to match those in my table here. These harvest targets are one solution to smoothing out harvest levels throughout the planning horizon. They were derived by trial and error and represent one possible solution for a transition to long-term sustainable yield. We carry out a run using these new flow targets, and you can see how harvest and growing stock have stabilized in the long term. This gives us more confidence in the long-term sustainable yield estimate than those found in our previous runs.